YouTube, this is a VQ. We're doing a combat mission, Battle for Normandy, after action report. The mission is the Copse. It is one of the very, very small ones from the new battle pack that's just been released. The Great Swan, is it? I just know it's Battle Pack 1. Anyway, so basically we are in north of Paris, racing across west-east towards the Belgian frontier. And the Germans are in disarray. They're fleeing back east as fast as they can go. We are part of the Sherman... Where is my briefing again? The Sherman Rangers. Okay, so we're from Nottingham. And maybe a bit of... I've got to throw in a Robin Hood reference somewhere there. There's probably going to be a few more as well. Basically, yeah, it's the 31st of August 1944 and we are racing east. I've read this before. We are well ahead of our main column. Advancing forward, we've got no support except what's on the map, and in front of us we know there's just an ad hoc collection of Germans. A little note here that 15 different regiments from 8 different divisions over the last 36 hours, that's where the prisoners have come from. So, as I said, we really don't know what's in front of us. Only probably expecting an AT gun, maybe two, and some infantry to get past. Basically, we've got to get past that line of defence and then exit the US forces on the other end of the map. It's a very, very small map. Let's have a look at the points. I did see some points somewhere here. So there we go. So we got bonus already, 250 points. Destroy the blocking force, 250, but you get the most points for exiting forces. So force preservation is going to be key. And our force, here it is, so it's one platoon of Sherman, so two Sherman 5s and one Firefly. We've got a Stuart Kangaroo armoured personnel carrier. Don't see many of those. That's one of the vehicle pack from memory. The old Sherman Kangaroo. And a few half-tracks that will die as soon as anyone sees them. So I'm going to race a few of the tanks up initially. I'll maybe race this one up as well. So, and then I'll... Well, I was moving the Stuart, not the tank, but I will move the tank up as well. So I'll keep the base of fire in the centre here. I'm going to race also one of these squads of infantry up over here. On this side, they should be able to start getting a line of sight if there's any AT guns or anything hiding in the bushes. And I think we'll do that now. Lighter, even though it's a armored vehicle. No turret, takes a lot of weight off it. 10.9 tons versus 32 tons. A little bit too far forward than I hoped. No one shooting at him, that's the main thing. Absolutely no return fire, it's good. I may race up these half tracks. On the left there, we'll have two squads going through these trees here. There shouldn't be any contact there, but when they get to this wall they should... Oh, look at that perfect line of sight down into the trees here. Yeah, that should work really well. These guys don't have dedicated gunners though. That's be good to have the half tracks with their... I think they're 50 cows? Yeah, they're 50 cows. So it would be very, very good to leave those arms somehow. Actually bring out the mortar team there, next to useless. Okay. Anyway, been missing from action for a very long time, I know that. Apologies if you are a regular viewer, but real life has been absolutely chaos. Whoa, infantry! Oh. like they're mounted along the side of the ridgeline here. These two sets of foxholes. There's at least one Panzer track there waiting for me to go further. So anyway, yes, I understand, being away for a very long time, real life got in the way. Combination of work initially, injured dog looking after that on the weekends, and followed more recently by building a house. So anyone who's done that knows there's a lot of running around to do, chasing things up, getting quotes, bits and pieces every weekend, so very little time to actually record. When I have been playing the game, or other games, just haven't been up to just recording something at the same time and speaking to you all. Tell you what, let's put a little bit of HE there. No aim point. So, a little bit of MG can sit. Should have actually probably checked the ground conditions. High dry, yep, high to summer, so we're all good. Someone. I could put these troops up on the ridge line here, but I really just don't know what else is behind there, that's all. I think this is a bit of a trap. I could race the tanks very easily into this area and just blast them, but I reckon there's some nasties. Yeah, I reckon you go over this line here and everything's going to open up. Wouldn't be surprised if there's some like fire trigger or something as soon as you cross this line. So we'll maybe move up with the infantry here first. Whoa, we've got foxhounds directly in front of us though. Okay, let's change that to our hunt command. And let's approach that from two angles. Get behind them. So I may get you to cover over here. And we do have the half track. So great. So these guys will probably keep moving. These guys will hunker down. It's actually pretty silly move for the half track, and I can get take fire from this angle. Yep. Now get down. Okay, at least we know what's ahead of us. Yep, yep. Told you to get down. Two more over here, including the Sting gunner. Oh, another one goes down. Oh no. You idiots. Tell your buddy to get down. You don't jump up there. This is probably our first real look who we're facing. Oh, it looks like we've got SS. Well, he's surrendering. SS and regular here forces. Regular Wehrmacht. Take the gamble. His flank's sort of covered by these trees, so I'm guessing that would be alright. He can just lay down the fire down here. Clear that ridge line for these infantry to advance. Looks like a full line of infantry here. Get the steward up actually. From here he can actually do some damage. He's got a bow MG, but better than nothing. That'd be a good spot for him actually. 30 cow, pretty sure. So we move the half track. That was close. Also, this armoured force here may also provide a little bit of cover. Hard cover for the infantry advancing. That's what I'm looking for. I don't know what you're still shooting at. Get moving again. So we get the Stuart firing. We can put some fire straight over these two foxholes, that'd be ideal. Just want suppression, that's all I want. Let's hit a tree. I may have to live with just this foxhole, but it's better than nothing. Oops. Assaulting, but I will. Let's change that tactic around a bit. And wait for those guys. Looks like they're bugging out. Someone's bugging out. Surrendered. Looks like everyone else has fled. looks like these guys, they know that these guys bugged out. They don't know where they are, but look at that final bit of buddy aid. Pick up the SMG and we'll push forward. Looks like I'm gonna ban this. This is just a picket line by the looks of it. Same as over there. These is very open ground. And I could come around here first. I'm starting to really not like this idea. Get up on this little thing here and these guys can just shoot at me. No end. I reckon there's at least another full squad on that side and that side. Probably an AT gun scattered around there somewhere. So I don't forget. So yeah, that's the problem with these transports. They don't have dedicated gunners. You around. Bring me around like so, what do you say? Pick up the SMG, that's a shame. Saying that though, they're probably gonna sit here for most of them and just have a long range shootout with anyone in those other trees. Really want to try and get these squads up at the same time, get some tanks up at the same time, just overwhelm anything in those tree lines. Probably got at least one of the tanks up there, maybe the Stuart and those two squads hitting at the same time. Maybe even the half track and feeling sacrificial. Watch this heavy forest there. Creeping through just a little bit. So I've got these two squads, we'll get in their positions and they'll race to the wall. Oh wow, I spotted first. Whoa, here we go. Radios, turn the radios on. 50 mil, front armor. Ugh. Oh, thank God. Didn't expect it to be there, actually. I'm not on the road. Not doing any damage, just a bit to the optics, not much. That was a 75 or a 76, that would have been a dead Sherman. So we'll look at that up again close. Look at it from the German point of view. Yeah, hull down, first shot goes over the top. Oh, there it is. Right there. And immediately gets taken out. Correct hit. I'm guessing as well, probably a reduced crew. In fact, it's in the open like that, I think we would have seen all the crew pretty much immediately. Slow reload times is the result. Alright, no guts, no glory. Don't want to lose the half tracks. I'm going to need them to transport the troops out of here in a quick order. This... just had a thought. This mission could get very, very easy once upgrade 4 comes along. We get tank riders on the Western Front. Just race them straight down. What I'm thinking there is I need those half tracks to mount these guys back up once the resistance is taken care of and race forward. But if the half tracks die post upgrade 4, I still use the tanks to do the same thing. So just think you fought all the way through Normandy and now you're still in your bellies. Same time too, which is good. Expect to hear a sniper fire any second now. Possibly another infantry contact over there. Yeah, let's fire a few rounds over there. We've got the ammo, might as well. Just in case that was a contact. In fact, you guys aren't coming up to fire. Yeah, infantry thought so. Feel free to shoot. Him, he didn't get away, but